So also, doctor, if you can please educate the audiences about the stages of labor.
There are four stages of labor. First stage is from 4 centimeter dilatation, like patient comes in pain. You assess the patient by assessing the dilatation of the uterus, the cervix. The cervix. Cervix is a part of uterus which opens up during pregnancy and the baby delivers out. So there are 4 stages of pregnancy. During first stage, the cervix gets open from 4 centimeter till 10 centimeter. 10 centimeter is the delivery occurs. So first stage is dilatation of cervix from 4 to 10. Then second stage is from full dilatation, like 10 centimeter dilatation, to the delivery of the baby. This is second stage of labor. Then third stage is after the delivery of the baby, postpartum period. Immediately after the, from the delivery, immediately after the delivery to another 1 hour postpartum. Post-delivery, 1 hour. So this is the third stage of labor. So these three stages are very important. These should be monitored very carefully. There are high risk chances of fetal getting distressed during this labor period, because the mother experiences contraction. Her abdomen gets tight during contractions. The baby gets squeezed in the mother's abdomen. So that should be monitored very carefully. Plus, post delivery, there is a very high risk of bleeding, which is in medical terms known as postpartum hemorrhage. So that is very common and very, very, very dreadful complication. If a person bleeds, if a person bleeds uncontrollably, then it might even lead to severe complications or ICU admissions. So that should be monitored very carefully. We should look for any tears post-delivery, there's any tear in the vagina or something like that. Or some products get retained, the placenta does not deliver out. So, bleeding might have.
So, before I let you go, because, you know, we have very less time. So, like I said, so, doctor, before I let you go, one last question to you is, does, you know, because of the pandemic and COVID everywhere, so does having COVID-19 affect the delivery and also the postpartum care?
Actually, personally saying, I've experienced a lot of intrauterine death during this COVID period. Like the baby has expired in uterine only, in utero. A lot of patients have come. They were fine till 7 or 8 months of delivery. Then suddenly 9th month, the fetus expires in utero. So it's a lot of patients. In the past 2-3 months to the last 3-4 months before this, the COVID era ended. In April, May.
When the virus was quite rampant.
So that time. So first risk is that only. So actually, this was our conclusion, all the gynecologists' conclusion, that all these are. Not me, there are other gynecologists also. They have experienced the same. So this was our conclusion that might be due to COVID, because nothing can be proven, but this was our conclusion. For the first time, we have seen all this, so many IUDs. So this was our conclusion that was because of COVID-19. And post-delivery, see, if a female acquires COVID-19, she needs to be separated from her baby, which is the most crucial time. The first 40 days are the most important period when the baby requires.
But then what about breastfeeding?
If the baby has acquired COVID, then there is no need to separate mother and baby. She can continue breastfeeding. And there is no such study which says breastfeed releases COVID-19 virus. There is no such study. These studies have come that virus is only released through nasal secretions or mouth secretions. From the situation, not from the milk of the mother. So if the baby is also COVID positive, then there is no need to separate mother from baby. She can continue breastfeeding. But in case if mother is COVID positive, baby is negative, baby is not COVID positive, then the baby should be separated for isolated for some period. So that because right now, if you don't isolate, there are many post COVID complications. The COVID might affect baby's lungs, there might be some fibrosis.
Yeah.
Baby can acquire kidney problems later in life.
Okay. Okay. Thank you so much, Dr. Sakshi, for coming to the channel and, you know, educating us about all the questions that I asked you. Thank you so much. It was a great conversation.
Thank you so much. Thank you.